were wrong. Augustin Louis Cauchy was a French mathematician, engineer, and physicist who made pioneering contributions to several branches of mathematics, including mathematical analysis and continuum mechanics. He was one of the first to state and prove theorems of calculus rigorously. He almost single-handedly founded complex analysis and the study of permutation groups in abstract algebra. The Dutch mathematician Hans stated, "More concepts and theorems have been named for Cauchy than for any other mathematician. In elasticity alone, there are 16 concepts and theorems named for Cauchy." Cauchy was a high volume writer. He wrote approximately 800 research articles and 5 complete textbooks on a variety of topics in the fields of mathematics and mathematical physics. Cauchy remained a professor at the university until his death at the age of 67. His name is one of the 72 names inscribed on the Eiffel Tower. We now define what is a Cauchy sequence. A sequence An is said to be a Cauchy sequence or fundamental sequence if and only if, for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists a natural number m such that modulus of a suffix n plus p minus a suffix n is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equals to m and p is greater than 0. Here we are used if and only if. We can use either if and only if or if in a definition. In a definition, if we use if and only if, there is no difficulty at all. There is nothing wrong in it. We have some results. From the definition, it is clear that every Cauchy sequence is always bounded. If for at least one epsilon greater than 0, we have modulus of a n plus p minus a n is greater than epsilon. For all n greater or equal to m and p is greater than 0, then we say that the sequence a n does not converge. Now we will prove Cauchy general principle of convergence of a sequence, or it is also known as Cauchy convergence criterion. What is the statement? A sequence AN converges if and only if for each epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to n such that modulus of a suffix n plus p minus a suffix n is less than epsilon. For all n greater than or equals to m and p is greater than 0. If you look at this statement, in the statement we have if and only if. It means it has two parts, if part and only if part, or we say it has two parts, namely necessary condition and sufficient condition. What is the first part? The first part is necessary condition. In necessary condition, we are given that a sequence AN converges. What you have to prove? We have to show that for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists a natural number m such that modulus of an plus p minus an is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equals to m and p is greater than 0. That is the necessary condition. That is, the first part is given. We have to prove the second part. What is the second part? That is only if part or the sufficient condition. The sufficient condition is the reverse of the first part. That is, will be given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a natural number m such that modulus of an plus b minus an is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equals to m and p is greater than 0. What we have to prove? We have to prove that the sequence an converges. Now, first we'll prove the necessary condition. What is the necessary part? Necessary part is, the first thing is given. What is given? In the sequence an converges, we have to prove the second part. We have to prove the second part. Here we are given the sequence an converges. So let us consider the sequence an converges to L. Then by definition of convergence sequence, for epsilon greater than 0, there exists a natural number m such that modulus of an minus l is less than epsilon. But here we are using epsilon by 2. It is nothing wrong in it, because epsilon is less than epsilon by 2. What is epsilon? Epsilon must be very, 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 very small number, but positive. So epsilon is very small number. What about epsilon by 2? It is also very small number. And hence, in the place of epsilon, we can write epsilon by 2. Nothing wrong in it. I will tell you why we are writing epsilon by 2 here. Then, what about modulus of an plus p minus l value? What about the value? Assume that m is 10 lakh. The m value, that exceeds a natural number m, that is considered is a 10 lakh. By condition, what's the condition? N is greater than or equal to m. Therefore, n must be greater than or equals to 10 lakhs. Let us assume that n is equals to 10 lakhs 80. And also, what is p? P is positive. Let us take p equals to 20, which is greater than 0. Now, what is n plus p? N plus p is, n value is 10 lakhs 80, p is 20, and hence n plus p will be 10 lakhs 100. 10 lakhs 100. This inequality is true. This inequality is true. When it is true? It is true from mth term onwards. If m is 10 lakhs, what is n plus b? 10 lakhs 100. Therefore, if it is true for 10 lakhs, it must be true for 10 lakhs plus 1. 10 lakhs 2, 10 lakhs 3, 10 lakhs, any number which is greater than 10 lakhs. Therefore, n plus p is 10 lakhs 100, and hence modulus of n plus b minus l is also less than epsilon by 2 for all n greater or equal to m and p is greater than 0. Now, what do you have to prove? We have to prove that given epsilon, there exists m. Yes, m exists now. M exists now. Such that modulus of an plus p minus an is less than epsilon. Now our aim is to show that the value of modulus of An plus P minus An is less than epsilon. And hence, let us consider modulus of An plus P minus An. Now, An plus P minus An can be written as modulus of An plus P minus L plus L minus An. What here we have added and subtracted L. The value will not change. The above term can be written as An plus P minus L plus L minus An. We have grouped into two. We know that modulus of x plus y is less than or equals to mod x plus mod y. That is triangular inequality. If you consider An plus P minus L as x, L minus An as y, then this will be of the form modulus of x plus y. But what is modulus of x plus y? Which is less than or equals to mod x plus mod y. Therefore, it is less than or equal to modulus of An plus P minus L plus modulus of L minus An. Since modulus of A minus B is same as modulus of B minus A, this L minus An can be written as An minus L. An minus L. Now, what is the value of modulus of An plus P minus L? And what is the value of modulus of An minus L? As we discussed here, modulus of An minus L is less than epsilon by 2. Modulus of An plus P minus L is also less than epsilon by 2. That is, each term is less than epsilon by 2. And hence we have less than epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2 equals to L for all N is greater than or equals to M and P is greater than 0. Thus, we have proved that modulus of An plus P minus An is less than epsilon. Since we want to prove An, this modulus of An plus P minus An is less than epsilon, we considered modulus of An minus L is less than epsilon and modulus of An plus B minus L is also less than epsilon by 2, because we have two terms here. Therefore, we have taken each term is epsilon by 2. Suppose we have three terms here, then we have to consider each term is less than epsilon by 3. If you have four terms, we have to consider each term is less than epsilon by 4. Hence, for a given epsilon, there exists M belongs to N such that modulus of An plus P minus An is less than epsilon for all N greater or equal to M and P is greater than 0. That is the other part of it. And hence the condition is necessary for the sequence to be convergent. Sufficient part. Here we are given that for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists a natural number M such that modulus of An plus P minus An is less than epsilon for all N is greater than or equals to M and P is greater than 0. Now we have to prove the other part. What's the other part? That is, we have to show that the sequence An converges. To prove, let us first show that the sequence an is bounded. We know that the definition of bounded is a sequence an is bounded if there exist two real numbers l comma k such that l is less than or equal to an less than or equal to k for all n belong to n. That is, every term of the sequence an lie between the two real numbers l and k. For this, let us choose epsilon is equal to 1, which is positive, because epsilon must be positive. So 1 is a positive value, so let us choose epsilon is equal to 1. Then, by condition of the statement, what's the statement says? Epsilon greater than 0, then x is m belongs to n, such that modulus of an plus p minus an is less than epsilon for all n is greater or equal to m and p is greater than 0. We have chosen epsilon value, so epsilon is over. Now we have to, there must exist a natural number m. Now let us choose that number as m naught, such that modulus of an plus p minus an is less than epsilon. Since epsilon is equals to 1, we write less than 1 here. For all n is greater than or equals to m naught, because here we assume that there exists a natural number m naught and p is greater than 0. In particular, by taking n is equal to m naught, because what are the values of n? The values of n are n is equal to m naught or more than m naught. So there is an equality here, and hence let us take n is equal to m naught. Therefore, the above expression becomes, there is no m naught here because m naught is n. We have modulus of an plus p minus an less than 1 for all p is greater than 0. Here we should not write for all n greater or equal to n, m naught, because we have chosen the value of n. Therefore, we simply write for all p greater than 0. We know that modulus of x is less than a implies and implied by minus a less than x less than a. That is, when you remove this modulus sign, we get minus a less than x less than a. Similarly, we are going to remove the modulus here, and hence it becomes minus 1 less than a m naught plus p minus a m naught less than 1 for all p greater than 0. Now, adding a m naught so that we get a m naught minus 1 less than a m naught plus p. Here m naught minus a m naught get cancelled, less than 1 plus a m naught for all p greater than 0. Now let us choose k1. K1 is minimum of a1, a2, a3, so on, a m naught comma a m naught minus 1. Minus 1. So k1 will take minimum of any of these values. Any of these values. What is k2? K2 will be maximum of a1, a2, a3, so on, a m naught comma a m naught plus 1. Plus 1. Plus 1. Therefore, k2 will take maximum of any of these values. Now, by the choices of k1 and k2, we can write k1 is less than a n less than k2. That is, all the values of a n lie between k1 and k2. For all n belong to n. That's the one we have to prove. Thus, we have shown that every element of the sequence an lie between the two real numbers, namely k1 and k2. That is, an is bounded for all n belong to n. Since an is bounded by Bolzano Weierstrass theorem for sequence, a sequence an has at least one limit point. But we know that a bounded sequence having only one limit point converges. What's our aim? Our aim is to show that the sequence an converges. For that, we already proved that an is bounded. Now, if we show that this an has exactly one and only one limit point, then we say that an converges. For that, now we are going to show that the sequence an has exactly one limit point. How do you prove that an has exactly one limit point? The theorem assures that it has one or more limit points. Now we have to show that it has only one limit point. So what should we do is, as usual, we choose two such limit points. Suppose, our assumption, suppose, if possible, L1 and L2 be two different limit points of the sequence an to L2. Let us choose epsilon is equals to modulus of L1 minus 2, which is greater than 0. Because whether it is L1 is greater than L2 or L2 is greater than L1, when you take modulus, whose value will be positive. Therefore, we choose epsilon is equal to modulus of L1 minus L2. Now, the given condition. What's the given condition? The given condition is, epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to n, such that modulus of an plus b minus an is less than epsilon, for all n is greater than or equal to m and p is greater than 0. That is, with the difference, an plus b minus an is less than epsilon. So, there exists m belongs to n, because we have chosen epsilon already. The x is m belongs to n, such that modulus of an plus b minus an is less than epsilon by 3. We know that epsilon is small, epsilon by 3 is so small. So it's not a problem at all. For all n is greater than or equals to m and p is greater than 0. Since L1 and L2 are two limit points of the sequence an, by the definition of limit point of the sequence, every neighborhood of L1 and L2 contains infinitely many terms of the sequence an. What do you mean by this? When it is a limit point, then what happened? L is a limit point of the sequence an, then given epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to n, such that modulus of an minus l, because l is the limit point, modulus of an minus l is less than epsilon for all n is greater than or equals to m. But here, we already chosen epsilon. So, epsilon is over. Also, there exists m belongs to n. M belongs to n is also over. Now, what do you have to write? Since L1 is a limit, in the place of L, we are going to write L1. Similarly, L2 is a limit, in the place of L, we are going to write L2. Therefore, since L1 and L2 are the limits of the limit points of the sequence an, there exists N1, N2 belong to N, such that for N1 is greater than M and N2 is greater than M, we can write modulus of A suffix N1. Here N, therefore we have written N. But here n1, therefore we write n1 minus l1 less than epsilon by 3. Call it as 2. And since l2 is the limit point of the sequence an, there exists n2 belongs to n, and n2 is greater than m, we have modulus of an2 minus l2 is less than epsilon by 3. Therefore, since n1 comma n2 greater than m, the condition 1, what is the condition 1? The condition 1 is this. What is this? Modulus of an plus b minus an is less than epsilon by 3. Here we have n. Therefore, we wrote an plus b minus an. That is, it is the inequality is true right from m onwards. Right from m onwards. M or more than m. Therefore, it is n is greater than m. So, greater than m. N plus b is also greater than m. And hence, since n1 and n2 are greater than m, we are going to replace n plus p by n1 and n by n2. Therefore, by this condition 1, we can write modulus of an1 minus an2 less than epsilon by 3. Let us call it as 4. Thus, we have 3 inequalities here. Modulus of an1 minus l1 less than epsilon by 3. Modulus of an2 minus l2 less than epsilon by 3. And the modulus of an1 minus an2 is less than epsilon by 3. Epsilon is equals to modulus of l1 minus l2. The same epsilon can be written as epsilon is equals to modulus of L1 minus AN1 plus AN1 minus AN2 plus AN2 minus L2. That is, we have added and subtracted AN1. Also, we have added and subtracted AN2. We know that the triangular inequality is modulus of x plus y is less than or equal to mod x plus mod y. This triangular inequality can be extended to any number of real numbers, any terms. Here we have only two terms, but here we are going to make it as three terms. Like the first term is L1 minus AN1. The second term as an1 minus an2. The third term is an2 minus l2. We are going to apply this triangle inequality for this modulus. Since the triangle inequality says that modulus of sum of the terms is less than or equals to, and hence we have here less than or equals to. The first term is L1 minus AN1, but we are writing this as AN1 minus L1 because modulus of A minus B is same as modulus of B minus A. Therefore, we are writing L1 minus AN1 as AN1 minus L1 plus second term modulus of an1 minus an2 plus the third term an2 minus l. What are the values of modulus of an1 minus l1, modulus of an1 minus an2, and modulus of an2 minus l2? If you recall, the inequalities 2, 3 and 4, what are they? Inequality 2 is modulus of an1 minus l1 is less than epsilon by 3. 3 says modulus of An2 minus L2 is less than epsilon by 3. 4 says modulus of An1 minus An2 is less than epsilon by 3. That is, each one of the modulus is less than epsilon by 3. And hence, the first one, the value of the first one is less than epsilon by 3. The second modulus is also less than epsilon by 3. The third one is also less than epsilon by 3. And hence, which is less than epsilon by 3 plus epsilon by 3 plus epsilon by 3 is equals to epsilon. Thus, where we have started? We have started with epsilon and arrived at again epsilon. But between these two epsilon, what are the expressions we have? Here we have equal, equal, less than or equal, less than. And hence, therefore, epsilon is less than epsilon. Is it true? Can you say 5 is less than 5? Can you say 2 is less than 2? Can you say minus 5 is less than minus 5? No, no, no. And hence, which is a contradiction. Why this contradiction? Why this contradiction? Because of a supposition. What is our supposition? Our supposition is, suppose, if possible, L1 and L2 be two different limit points of An. That is, L1 is not equals to L2. This is our supposition. So, we have arrived at a contradiction because our supposition is wrong. What we assumed is wrong. Since we assumed that L1 is not equal to L2, is wrong. Therefore, what is right? L1 must equals to L2. Therefore, the two limits are equal. Both are nothing but one and the same. One and the same. Therefore, the sequence An contains exactly only one limit point. As we know that a bounded sequence having only one limit point is convergent. Therefore, the sequence An is convergent. Hence, the condition is sufficient. This proves the theorem.
Now, results. The results are important to answer. Every convergent sequence of real number is a Cauchy sequence. To prove that, every convergent sequence of real number is a Cauchy sequence, we simply produce the proof of necessary part of Cauchy convergence theorem. To prove every Cauchy sequence of real numbers is bounded, for that we have to reproduce the proof of sufficient part of the proof up to boundedness. To show that every Cauchy sequence of real numbers is convergent, we simply produce the proof of sufficient part of Cauchy general convergence theorem for sequences. So, combining all the above three, Cauchy general principle of convergence can be restated as a sequence of real numbers converges if and only if it is a Cauchy sequence. plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by plus so on 1 by n. Here also 1 by n. So that when you find the difference, all the terms which are in blue color get cancelled. Therefore, we get modulus of 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 so on 1 by n plus b less than epsilon for all n is greater than or equals to m and b is greater than 0. This implies 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 plus so on 1 by n plus b is less than 1 by 2 for all n greater than equal to m and b is positive. We have removed the modulus. Modulus is not required because n is positive and b is positive. All the terms are positive, hence we need not write modulus. Now, we are going to keep n is equal to m. What is n? N is equal to m or more than m. We take n is equal to m. Then what happened? Replace every n by m. Therefore, the MOE inequality becomes 1 by m plus 1 plus 1 by m plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 by m plus b, which is less than 1 by 2 and the b is greater than 0. What is b? B is greater than 0. What is m? M is positive. Let us take b equals to 2 m. Then the MOE inequality becomes 1 by m plus 1 plus 1 by m plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 by m plus the place of b, we write 2 m. We write 2 m. Now, m is equal to m. Adding 2 m on the right side, 1 on the left side. Now, m is equal to m. Adding 2 m on the left hand side and 1 on the right hand side. Since m is positive and its large value, 2 m is greater than 1. Therefore, m is equal to m becomes m plus 2 m is greater than m plus 1. Write its reciprocal. 1 by m plus 2 m is less than 1 by m plus 1. Whenever we multiply an inequality with a negative number, or when you take reciprocal, the inequality will be reversed. The same thing can be written as 1 by m plus 1 is greater than 1 by m plus 2 m. Similarly, 1 by m plus 2 is greater than 1 by m plus 2 m because m is not a value. Continue the same what we have. 1 by m plus 1 plus 1 by m plus 2. Then we have 1 by m plus 2 m. Therefore, if we continue this, 1 by m plus 2 m, 1 by m plus 2 m, 1 by m plus 2 m is equals to 1 by m plus 2 m. But we need the sum. We need the sum of all the terms. Therefore, adding all these things, left hand side we get 1 by m plus 1 plus 1 by m plus 2 so on 1 by m plus 2 m. Greater than, what's the right hand side? 1 by m plus 2 m, 1 by m plus 2 m, 1 by m plus 2 m. Same factor. How many such factors we have? It is very clear that there are 2 m factors. Look at this here. First to 1, 2. How many terms are there? 2 m terms are there. Therefore, when we adding all the above, we get 1 by m plus 1 plus 1 by m plus 2 so on 1 by m plus 2 m, since they are all M. M, M cancel and H we get, which is greater than 2 by 3. And hence, in the next step, look at this. The sum is less than 1 by 2, but greater than 2 by 3. They're going to combine these two. They're going to combine these two. These two. Then we can write 2 by 3 is less than the sum 1 by m plus 1 plus 1 by m plus 2 plus so on. 1 by m plus 2 m is less than 1 by 2. That means 2 by 3 is. Yeah.